Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord, everybody. I just want to greet you in the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth. Wherever you are watching me right now, I pray that the Lord bless you. And I want to say up front that my name is Apostle Robinson Robbie Germain. I'm the senior pastor of the Tabernacle of Prayer and Deliverance Church located in Brooklyn, New York. The address is 3112 Tilden Avenue, Brooklyn, New York, 11226. And I'm telling you, people of God, that God is doing marvelous things in that church, in that local church with a global vision. So viewers from all over the United States of America, viewers from all over the world, I greet you once again in the name of Jesus. I believe from the bottom of my heart that this show that you are watching right now is going to be a blessing for you, going to be a blessing in your life, going to be some type of edification and vivification for your soul, for your spirit, and for you in the name of Jesus. So bear with me, be with me, and I believe that not only that God has a word for you today, but he also has a miracle for you. Before we go any further, I think it's going to be proper for us to pray, to invite the Holy Spirit to be with us right now, because I believe that it's a God-ordained moment. That's what we call in theology the Kairos moment, a moment set up by God. So quickly, wherever you are, I want you to bow your head and quickly listen to me. Amen. Heavenly Father, in the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth, I come before your throne right now with those people of yours watching me from all over the globe. I say thank you for everything you've done in our life. We want to say thank you, Lord, for everything that you are doing right now in our life. In the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth, as we are thanking you, God, we are asking for forgiveness. Anything that we have done against your will, against your way, we ask for forgiveness, because your word say, God, if we confess our sins, you are just and fair to forgive us. So tonight, God, today, this morning, whatever the time it is for those people who are watching me, we ask for forgiveness. And as we are thanking you, God, as we are also asking for forgiveness, we pray that this moment that we are spending together be a moment of extraordinary rokoshata, a testimony for those who are watching me. In the name of Jesus, we take authority right now to bind any contrary force, to bind any spirit that is not from you that could hang what is taking place right now through this show. We pray, God, not because we are worthy, but we pray in the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth. To him be the glory forever and ever. Amen and amen and amen. So, people of God, be ready. Be ready. God has a word for you. There's a prophetic word coming your way today. In this show, I firmly think that you are not watching this show by chance, by coincidence. The Lord wanted you to be in front of your tablet, in front of your computer, in front of your phone, in your living room, in your bedroom, to watch this show. Well, God gonna use me for you. We're gonna take a short break as we are going to the time of worship, and we'll be right back. Stay tuned. Welcome back. Welcome back. This is the top show, the Tabernacle of Prayer and Deliverance show. Entering your house, entering your life with the power of the living God. I want to say before we get into the word, because the word is very important to us in this show, because the word can change somebody's life. The word can allow you to take another level. The word can allow you to take another dimension in God. But before we go into the word, I just want to remind you that the Lord has something special for you today. Oh, Ramashatake. Something special is coming your way. And I believe from the bottom of my heart, I have to say it again, that you are not watching by coincidence. You're not watching this show by chance. Again, I'm Apostle Robinson Robbie Germain from the Tabernacle of Prayer and Deliverance Church. You need to hear this because God is doing great things. God is moving mightily with this church located in Brooklyn, New York. Now, let's go quickly to the word. What came to my spirit to share with you today is found in Matthew chapter 6, verse 33. I mean, a lot of people know about these verses, but today I want to remind you the significance and importance of this word. Let's go quickly to Matthew chapter 6, verse 33. It's not a sermon, but I just want to share this verse with you today. As the Lord put it in my spirit as I was coming here. It says, but seek ye first the kingdom of God and his righteousness, and all these things shall be added unto you. But seek ye first the kingdom of God. Allow me, ladies and gentlemen, brothers and sisters watching me right now, that the first thing you need in your life is not a man. The first thing you need in your life is not a woman. The first thing that you need as I'm talking to you right now is not money. The first thing that you need to seek is the kingdom of God. The first thing you need to long for, to look after, to search for is God and his kingdom. You know, it is very simple. I just don't want to make a complicated statement by saying, by putting Greek words, going to theology and all those. No, it is simple. When you seek God first, when you try to put God first in your life, I'm telling you, all what you need will come automatically because God wants you to seek him. God wants you to seek his righteousness. Remember, the Hebrew people, the Jewish people, they know one of the names of God is Jehovah Tzidkenu, from the Hebrew word Tzidek, which means righteousness, which means justice. I'm talking to you right now. It's not about running after money. It's not about running after success. But first, seek the kingdom of God, and everything else shall come into place at the right time, at the right moment. There's one person at least watching me right now, looking at me right now. God, I feel it so strong in my spirit. God is looking for a relationship with you. God wanna let you understand that he is your father. And as your father, he can take care of you. Oh, it is strong in my spirit that you need to turn and say, God, finally, I surrender. Finally, I come to a point where my life is truly in your hands. And if my life is in your hands, there's no way I'm going to fail. There's no way I'm gonna have to cry. There's no way that I'm going to look into my life after a while and say, What a debacle. What a waste time. What a wasted time. So do what you gotta do. Do the right thing by seeking God first, by allowing God to be first in your life, and all the sorrow, the pain that you're going through, that the confusion that is trying to get a hold on you will not be able to see Roko Shete Labada, but you will testify and say, this is a word for today. But seek ye first the kingdom of God and his righteousness, and all these things shall be added unto you. Matthew chapter 6, verse 33. We're going to take a break and we will be right back.
Lord, we worship you. We worship you, Lord. Lord, we are in your presence. You see the beauty.
Welcome back to the Tabernacle of Prayer and Deliverance Church show. Listen up. I want to tell you for real that God is faithful, that God is real, that God is alive. You see, in our church, I like to say to people, we pray and God does the rest. We pray and God delivers. Do not worry about anybody that is telling you that you don't need a miracle, that you don't need deliverance, that you don't need prayer. This is a big lie from the pit of hell. This is a big lie from the devil himself. We all need prayers. We all need to seek God's face. We all need to go before the Lord and say, Lord, I need you. I need you more than ever. So, and that's one of the reasons why we believe that this show is going to encourage you to seek God more. This show is going to encourage you to let the Lord be Lord in your life. Once again, I believe that those moments that you're going to spend with me through this show for the years to come will always be a blessing to your life. I think that someone watching me right now need a prayer. And after this prayer, we're going to make some declarations. As you are sitting in your car, in your couch, at home, at your job, you're going to need to declare those things, because my father, my spiritual father, Pastor Alf Lukau, always says, a closed mouth is a closed destiny. Let me say that again. A closed mouth is a closed destiny. Let's pray together. Heavenly Father, in the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth, I come before your throne once again. With those watching me right now who need you more than ever, I sense in my spirit, Lord, that someone watching me tonight, watching me today, needs a miracle. Somebody watching me right now, God, needs a touch from you, a divine touch. Someone watching me right now, God, need an intervention in his mind. The thought process, Korea Mandeleke Shata. Yes, Lord, need an intervention today. Too much confusion. Too much indecision. May you eliminate the spirit and the mind of that person right now, God, for your own glory. In the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth. As a matter of fact, I pray, God, that you remove any seed, any negative seed that was sown into the mind and spirit of that person right now. There's always hope in you. As long as we put our trust in you, hope shall be alive and manifestation shall follow hope and faith. So right now, increase the faith of those who need it. Increase the hope of those who feel like they are hopeless at this moment, God. And you will receive all the glory after you've done that. I remove all barriers of failure in the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth. May your name come, Rebe Shatakalab Soto Kodianda, into play when it comes to your servant, when it comes to your daughter, when it comes to your son watching me right now. I thank you in advance, and I believe, God, that you are still in the business of hearing, listening, and answering prayer. I pray with the conviction that you heard me today and you will give us a positive response for your own glory. And we pray in Jesus' mighty name. Amen. Amen. And amen. We'll be right back with the prophetic declarations.
Every Sunday, when my parents would take me to church, I always wanted to understand what the pastor was saying about God, Jesus, and the Bible. As a child, these things were hard for me to understand, hard for me to grasp, but that only made me more curious to understand what he was saying. Even though I didn't understand, I loved to hear the pastor preach on God's love for us. And I loved it most when he said this: God loved us so much that he sent his son to die for our sins. But what did that really mean? I was so eager to understand God's love for me. But as a child, I didn't get it. Jesus died on the cross for me. When my grandma would pray with me, she would always say, "Thank you, Father, for your love." That helped me understand the love of God that the pastor and my grandma was always talking about with the love that my own dad has for me. My dad loves me with an unconditional love. He tells me that I am the apple of his eye and that I am a spitting image of his. My mom always says that God's love is greater than any love in this whole world could have for me. As a child, it was hard for me to understand this love. If God's love is greater than any other love, I was so eager to understand this love. This love is a love that is greater than any other love. Even the love of my mom and dad has for me. I need to know. I want to know this experience, this love that's greater than the love that my mom and dad gives me. I need to experience with this love that made God give his son for me. What kind of love is greater than all the love in the world? Auntie Tete always said that this love is for everyone. Today, I know that I'm not too young to experience this love.
Well. Unfortunately, in everything, there's a beginning and there's an end. We are almost, yes, it's the end. But before we leave you tonight or today, depending on where you're watching us today, the Bible says in Job 22, verse 28, Yah shall declare it. Yah shall decree it, and it shall be established. There are certain things that you say with your mouth. It is established in the spirit realm, and the Lord put a seal on it. So today, before we leave this show, I'm going to make some declarations, some prophetic declarations. And I want you to bear with me, because the word of God says, when two or three agree to ask God for something, he will do it in the name of Jesus. Are you ready? Are you ready? Let's go. I declare and decree that you shall not die before your time. In the name of Jesus. I declare and decree that any demonic seed deposited in your spirit shall be removed by the Holy Spirit of God as I'm talking to you right now. in the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth. I declare and decree that any accident programmed by the spirit world, by the demonic world, shall not prosper, shall not come to pass. In the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth, I declare and decree that no weapon formed against you shall prosper in the name of Jesus. And I declare and decree that any tongue that is rising against us, against you, shall be condemned according to the word of God in the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth. Any spirit of failure following you since you were born or since you were a little girl or a little boy, we stand against that spirit right now and we declare and decree the fire of the Holy Spirit against that spirit in the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth. Why would you die before your time? Why would you die before your time? I shall not die. I shall live and I shall declare the benefits of the Lord. This is the word of God. In Roko Shete Ramandele. I mean, if I were you, I will repeat those words. I shall not die. I shall live. I shall declare the benefits of the Lord. This is basic Christianity, basic word of God. Just apply it. Use it. And you will see how God gonna take you out of some situations where you could have lived Rosatata, Yekorama. You could have left your life, but you're gonna leave to continue to say to whoever wanna hear you that God is good, that God is faithful, that God is alive, that God is God with your Roboshata. With your life. Once again, my name is Apostle Robinson, Robbie Germain, the senior pastor of the Tabernacle of Prayer and Deliverance Church. And this is the top TV show, the mediatic branch of this church with a local location, but with a global vision. I'll see you next time. And in the meantime, remember that Jesus loves you very much, and I do too. See you next time. God bless you.